Most people don't realize you can actually do this and this and this, all inside Apple Notes on your iPhone.
I've used Notes for years, and I still find new ways to use it almost every day. So in this video, I'm breaking down 10 features and tips that actually make Notes faster, smarter, and way more fun to use. If you've updated to iOS 26, you've probably noticed everything looks cleaner, shinier, and kinda bougie. The search bar moved to the bottom, the share button is now over here, and the three dots open your other options. When you select text, you'll notice a new arrow. Tap that to access even more tools. And if you long press a note, you'll see shortcuts like pin, lock, or share. Okay, so this one's my favorite. The new toolbar above your keyboard is now scrollable. You can swipe left or right to see everything, all in one spot. And the best part is it's smart. If you highlight a single word, you'll see certain formatting tools appear at the bottom. Highlight a paragraph and it switches to different layout options. If you want to format titles and headings, just tap AA. It's one of those updates that make you go, "Finally, Apple, this makes sense." This is one of those features that's underrated in my opinion. Go to your control center, in edit mode, search for note, and select add quick note. Now, whenever you have an idea, just swipe down and tap that quick note button. The best part is if you're in Safari, Mail, or Maps, it can auto link to what you're looking at. So now your notes stay in context. I love this for collecting recipes or journaling about random things that make me smile during the day. You can also add links to existing notes. For example, I keep a running list of songs that I've been loving lately. So when I'm in Spotify, I can share the track straight to notes and save it to my weekly mood boost list. Tap the paperclip icon and select record audio, or long press the Notes app icon and hit record audio. There's no need to even open the app first. It's great for lectures, quick voice dumps, or those 3 a.m. thoughts. And when you're done, tap the three dots on the audio file to add the transcription to your note. You can then read back what you said later. And this is super helpful if you think out loud like I sometimes do. Inside any note, tap the three dots and tap recent notes and scroll down the list. You can jump between what you've just opened without scrolling back through folders. If you've got long notes like personal planning, class notes, or brainstorming ideas, you can collapse headings. Just tap the little arrow next to the heading to hide everything underneath. It keeps your notes clean and way easier to navigate, so there's no more endless scrolling. Tags basically turn notes into a mini productivity hub. Just type a hashtag anywhere, like hashtag work, hashtag recipes, or hashtag ideas, and Notes automatically groups those together. Tap a tag at the bottom of the app to see every note with that tag. You can even filter for multiple tags. It's giving Notion vibes, but without the setup headache. If you want to hide private notes, long press a note and tap lock note. It will then require Face ID or your password to open it. Just make sure to tap the lock to lock your note. This is perfect for journaling, personal lists, or anything you'd rather keep private. You can even lock the entire app by long pressing the Notes app icon and tap require Face ID. You can drag one folder into another to keep notes tidy. To create a new folder, tap the folder icon and pick iCloud or on my iPhone. And inside a folder, tap the three dots and click Add Folder to create subfolders. When you long press a folder or note from the list or gallery view, you get a preview of what's inside. And now Notes shows you the number of items in each folder. Or if you want to move a folder in the main folders window, tap Edit and use the three lines to move the folder around. To share a folder, long press the folder and tap Share. You can decide if the person you share it with can edit or just view the folder. This is great for shared projects, trip planning, or even family errands. If you type an equation with three variables, Apple Notes can now generate 3D graphs, which you can then resize and live edit. It's basically a built-in graphing calculator and something I would have loved when I was back in high school. Now, here's a quick one before we wrap up. If you long press the Notes app icon on your home screen, you'll get instant shortcuts to start a new note, make a checklist, or even scan a document. Now, the scan feature's actually really handy and something that I often use. And if, at some later stage, you decide you need to scan any extra pages into an existing note, you can just tap the icon here, tap the image, select Scan Pages, and scan an additional page, and it will drop this new scan page right in. Now you can swipe through all of the scan pages inside OneNote. You can even tap the arrow next to the name to change the image size. You can zoom in and out with pinch gesture and add typed notes underneath the scanned images. Tap the arrow next to the name and tap copy. Then go to your other note, tap the icon here, then tap the three dots on the page and select paste. Then you can reorder the pages by long pressing on it and moving it to its new position. And here's the final bonus inside a bonus. You can add note shortcuts to your control center to jump into a recent or pinned note. Just search for shortcuts, tap choose app, and pick notes. Then you get to pick what you want to do. So with the open note option, you can get quick access to even a specific note. So whilst Apple Notes might look simple, it's secretly one of the most underrated apps on your iPhone. If you've been using it for just lists or reminders, try these features. You'll use it in a whole new way. And if I missed your favorite trick, drop it down in the comments. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Okay, bye.